In today's video, we are going to understand about Millikan's oil drop experiment. In 1909, Robert Millikan and Harley Fletcher conducted the oil drop experiment to determine the charge of an electrode. They suspended a tiny charged droplet of oil between two conducting plates or electrodes by balancing downward gravitational force with the upward drag and electric forces. With this experiment, they literally hang a droplet between two conducting plates and observed the charge and observed the different forces and then calculated all the physical value, and that's how they calculated the charge on an electrode. So now we will discuss the different parts of this kit and I will explain how will be the experiment conducted with this kit. So this is our trainer kit of Millikan's oil drop experiment. In this kit, the order code for this kit is 19204401.9A. So these are the different parts of this kit. In this is the air-free chamber. From this, the droplets can be formed inside the chamber. This is the covering of this chamber. This can be placed here. And this is the atomizer in which the oil will be filled and spraying or droplets will be given in the air-free chamber. This is the oil bottle will be provided with this kit here. And these are the circuit description and the so these are the two screens over there in this kit. This show the voltage. This is the DC high voltage because the experiment works on very high voltage. And these are the timers screen. The timer start or reset button is here. Whenever the timer will be resetted after this after pressing this reset button, and the pause button to pause the timer at any point. This is the balance and measurement key. When using in measurement, this will be pressed downwards, and when in balance, the voltage will be supplied. So that key will be in upward direction. So now I move on to the further. This is the video output connector, and this is the power and input connector to the camera. The microscope also installed here to observe the droplets, because the droplets are very tiny. That can only be observed with the microscope. The output of this microscope through this camera will be fed to this LED TV. The LED TV output can be connected through this table. So, and this is the pump to give the spray droplets, and this is the on-off switch to on and off this kit. We are also providing a user manual in which the detailed theory and experiment will be given in the user manual, and the LED also provided with this to observe the output of microscope and camera. So the schematic diagram of oil drop chamber is given in the manual as well, and I will explain the physical appearance of these all parts, which will the different parts of this oil drop chamber. So we will start with the oil fog chamber. This is the oil fog chamber. This is the oil fog hole over there. This is the windproof hood, so wind cannot be affected, the droplets cannot be affected with wind. This is the upper plate electrode here. This is the ebonite ring, so this will be so this ring will be insulating both the conducting plates. Now the underplate electrode is here, and bottom plate also. The upper cover plate is this, and oil fog inlet is inside the oil fog chamber. Spreader spring of upper plate electrode. This is the spreader spring of upper plate electrode, and this is the base of oil drop box. So this is the description of oil box drop, oil box oil drop chamber. This is the main part of this experiment. In this, the whole experiment will be conducted. So this is an atomizer. The oil will be filled in this atomizer. The atomizer can be opened like this, and the oil will be filled inside this section, and the atomizer will be closed and placed as its position. And as we pump the atomizer, the oil drop can be easily come out from this hole and will be inserted in the oil fog chamber. So now we will assemble the oil drop chamber. So this is the windproof hood will be placed like here, and this hole will be aligned with the microscope. The microscope adjustment bolt is here, so this will be adjusting the microscope. The microscope is adjusted properly. Now we will place, and this hole will be in matching with the atomizer. The oil drop chamber is installing will be installed like this, and this is the appropriate to cover the oil drop chamber. So now we will connect the video output through this cable. This groove matching this by matching this groove, we can easily connect this connector inside here. And tighten the safety screw. Now the output section of this cable will be connected to the video input of the HDMI TV. So this will be the section, and that's how we connect the TV with this. Now we will start the experiment and explain the how the experiment works.
Go.
So now the setup has been completed and we will be start this kit. So the kit has started and the timer started running because it's at the start position. As I press the pause button, the timer is paused, and as I start this timer, the timer continuously starts run. And if we want to reset the timer, we can press the reset button. This is the voltage. At this time, the voltage is supplied 141 volt DC as the switch is in the balancing mode. And as we press this, the measurement mode, the maximum voltage from this knob at the measurement mode will be only 4 volts. And in the balance mode, the voltage can be goes to around 900 volt DC, and at the minimum, it will be 0. Or 141. Now to observe the output from this oil chamber, we will turn on the TV. So this is the output right now. These are the horizontal and line section also provided at the TV to observe the fall and rise time of the droplets. We can measure and we can refer these lines to the upper section and the lower line. From this, in between this line, we will be calculated the rise time and fall time of the droplets. So right now the microscope's output is shown at the TV. These are the viewed of the microscope camera, and unresolved points of diffracted light and images are transmitted to the monitor screen. When the spray droplets spray is coming to the oil fog chamber, the microscope will be adjusted and we will see the little tiny diffracted resulted points of light as in the drops. So now when we pump this atomizer, the droplets pass through this oil chamber and inside the oil fog oil drop chamber, and we adjust the microscope and we will see the droplets as a light refracted point. You can see in the television, these are the droplets. For experiment, we will need to select any of these droplets and we will observe the motion of this droplet from upwards to downwards and downwards to upwards and calculate the different values. Now as the droplets pump through this atomizer, they ionized and they will be affected by the electric charge. So as we on the voltage of this section, you can see the droplets affected and moves upwards. The droplets they are moved upwards are positively charged, and the droplets that are going downwards will be negatively charged through the atomizer. So as we see, the droplets are in the free form, the no electric influence is present here. As we start the voltage, some of the droplets downwards movement goes slow. This is due to the droplets are negatively charged and attracted by the positive upper plate of the oil fog chamber. The motion of this droplet can be reversed like this droplet you are seeing by increasing the voltage, and the droplets at increasing the voltage goes driftly to the downwards are positively charged. The positively charged droplets are not be considerable. We will only use the negatively charged droplet in this experiment. So now we move on to our main experiment. For this we will first explain this experiment in dynamic mode. The dynamic mode, there will be no voltage uses, and the free fall time of the droplets will be measured. For first we will spray from this, we will give a spray from this atomizer and observe the droplet by adjusting the microscope properly. So now we have to select any of the droplet at which will we have to calculate all the data. For this we will select two lines, and the distance can be measured and already written in the manual of between two lines. So this is the top line and this is the down line. Any of the two lines can be selected while doing the experiment, and any drop which is selected, the whose fall time, free fall time without any voltage affection is calculated with this meter. So now if we want to up the drop, just adjust the voltage and make any drop as stable as you can by adjusting the voltage again and again. And now as I remove the voltage, that let us assume we will select this drop and this started falling freely. So as it reached this line, we will start the timer like this. The timer has started, and now we will wait till the drop reaches the bottom line, and we will pause the time when the drop reaches the bottom line. As it's reached the bottom line and it at crossing, I have stopped, pause the timer, and the time we will get is 17 seconds. Now calculate the distance between these two lines and you have got the time. You can easily find out the velocity at free fall of this droplet. So now our droplet is at the down position. Now we have to calculate the rise time. For rise time we will provide voltage. For this we have provided voltage, that's why the drop is almost in hang position. As we increase the voltage, the drop starts rising at some suitable voltage, and we will start the timer for rising. Again, as I remove the power source, the droplets automatically fall down, and as I start, the droplets stop. And now we will start the timer when the droplet cross the bottom line after increasing the voltage. So start the timer, and now we will observe the rise time of this droplet. So this is the rise time that we have calculated. Now immediately set the voltage at this drop, not move anywhere, because we need 2-3 or more readings of fall time and rise time again and again to get the better and accurate results. So now we will remove the power supply and reset the timer first, and remove the power supply and start the timer so that the fall time again can be measured. So we have measured the fall time like this, stop the timer and again start the power supply so the drop don't go anywhere. So this is the 4 second right now. As I increase the power, start the timer. This is the rise time. Now remove the power supply, start the timer and note down the reading. Also, when you remove and apply the power, the voltage needs to be write down, which should be same at fall time and rise time. So I remove the power and fall time calculated from these two lines, between these two lines. Reset the timer, take down the reading and start the voltage. So the drop again starts increasing and you will get the rise time. Right now start the timer and you will get the rise time at the voltage of 2 to 3 volt. So this is the right time, 8 seconds. Now we will put down this reading in the observation table given for the dynamic method. So we have taken the free fall time reading, this is the rise time reading, and mean fall time can be calculated the average of 5 readings, as in rise time also mean can be calculated. And now we will find out the velocity at this voltage. So now we will take the readings in balancing mode. For this, spray some drops, adjust the microscope and select any drop, like we have select this drop, and do not apply any voltage at this time and take down the free fall time of this droplet. So as it reaches this line, this will be considered as top line and this line considered the bottom line. Now we start the timer at this point. As the droplet goes down, the time will be taken. So we pause the timer and the time is taken 14 seconds. Now we will start the balancing mode. The drop should to be stopped like this. It's stopped and not going anywhere. Adjust and increase the voltage and try to balance the drop so that it do not move anywhere. So take different readings of voltages at this. The drop balanced with the all electric forces and gravitational forces. Try to balance the drop. That will take many practice. So here we can say the drop is almost balanced and not going anywhere. At this time we will note down the voltage, which is 141 volts. Take some more readings of free fall time by closing the balance mode. And drop is still here, not going anywhere. Adjust the voltage again and again. You need to be very patient for doing this experiment. This experiment need many practice and many readings will be taken to take the accurate results. After taking the readings of dynamic method and balancing method, write down these readings in the observation table and you will calculate it. The common constants of droplets all are given. The volume of the droplet will be calculated and the different forces which will be applied also calculated. And now when we calculate all the values, you will find the factor that will be affect the voltage and forces will be the accurate charge of the electron.